Today, I will be talking about crafting a sustainable career in the medical and health sciences. I would just like to take you through a little about career plan. So, you know that you need to plan. Planning is everything. Just having plans is not enough. You would agree with me that you need to plan. Very rightly said by Dwight Eisenhower. We need to plan and get into the process of planning. So, if you want to start crafting a career, you need to start with career planning itself. Mainly would be to know your values, your skills, learn about yourself first, be aware of your personality, your aptitude. I'll be touching on these points later as well. You also need to research some career options, look around what is available and link them to your values, your skills, your personality. Make sure that it's a good blend. Only then you're going to make the right choice and then you will be able to be successful and sustain your career. So some steps in selecting a study program would be, first, like I said, introspection. You need to know what you have a passion for. So what are your skills, what are your abilities, your personality? You can get this done through aptitude testing. Find out about yourself first. Then you need to know what is your preferred field. There are students who normally, after grade 12, they say, oh, I haven't really thought about it. But you should have. You should have. If you haven't, do it today. Do it tonight. Try to put down what is your preferred field. Because daily dying here and there is not really going to help you. So you need to know, to plan your career path, what are the kind of degree that you want. An associate's degree, an undergraduate degree, do you hope to do a post-graduation or a doctorate? All depends on what you're currently right now. Even if you're an undergraduate, planning for your post-graduation. So it's always upgrading yourself and trying to build up. The next thing you need to do is to prioritize your work preferences. Where would you like to work? What kind of a role would you like to play in an organization, for the community, or in a big organization, a small one? What kind of industry? Would it be in an office or would it be outdoors? So what is the kind of work preference that you have? The next thing for you to do would be just to make a preliminary career decision and make a plan of action as to what you would like to do. Because when you discuss this with a mentor or a counselor, you need to have something in mind. Because if you go there and you say, I'm totally confused, I don't know what to do, and you're not done your homework and background research, then it would be really difficult for you to discuss with someone else. So try to get these things clear. And then discuss it with maybe a family member, a mentor, a career counselor, and then finally make the decision. Now, after you make the decision and you have chosen what career path you want to take, what specific field or which program you want to join, make sure that you do a short internship or some part-time, one-time work, some community service, something which is related to the field, so that you get a feel of it and you actually start enjoying what you're doing. Personality is very important because you need to have a specific type of personality with a combination of certain traits which will help you to do well in certain fields. So there's this test called the Collins test, you probably heard of it. It gives you these Collins scores where you get a combination of these six areas which are specific to certain traits, as you can see in the picture there. So for the medical and health sciences, probably having a high score for investigative or social or realistic might help a lot more than the others. So once you know this, then it becomes a lot easier for you to know where your personality and career plans work together. So I'd like to give you a checklist when getting into this process of career planning. So the first thing what I would advise everyone is to start early. You must start early. Don't wait for the last minute or you'll miss the bus. Okay, now you don't want to miss that bus, right? So start early, start planning early. I know of students who already knew what they want to become as a professional when they were in grade 7 and 8. They already said, like there was a student who said, I want to become a cardiac surgeon at grade 7. And today she is one. This was many years ago when I was working in schools. And this is amazing because she already was so sure about it and she started planning at that young age. Now, even if you haven't started planning that early, like I said before, you can start tonight. Sit down and put down what you want to do. The next thing you need to do is not just going that I have a good ability for this or my interest is that, but if you do a psychometric test to find out your aptitude for certain areas, say like for numeric ability or spatial ability, or it could be mechanical reasoning. Okay, so you have these sub-tests there. So all of these come together as a battery of tests. So if you do an aptitude test, you could also do an interest test to find out where your interest actually lies, and together with a personality test. So you put these together, and then you are able to understand as to what material you are for a particular career. So then you can match the two. You would also need to explore STEM programs, careers, prospects. Like President just said, that there's no dearth of career opportunities. There's a lot out there, but it's very easy to say, oh, there's nothing out there for me. But there is. You just need to explore. You have everything around the Google, so you just one click and you know that there are so many options. So start exploring it, research, and find out what is that you have a passion for. Make sure you discuss with your parents and family. I'm sure the parents out there can be really happy to hear this, because sometimes, you know, because of lack of communication, you might not really be able to decide amicably about where you're going to study, how your finances are placed. Are you looking for a scholarship? Are you looking to relocate, or you need accommodation if you're traveling away from home, and your visa requirements? All of these things need to be discussed amicably. It should not result in a fight where you're not talking for days just because your parents don't agree with you, or your children don't agree with parents. Try to do this amicably, because it's a matter of a lifetime. Then the next step would be where applicable. If you have to do entrance exams, or some universities have interviews that they conduct, prepare for this in advance and be sure that you have the deadlines, the dates ready. So you need to know that this is the admission deadline for this particular university. You need to stay alert for these, because if you miss the deadline, then your application might not be accepted. And at the end of it, you need to make an informed career choice. Because making an informed career choice will ensure that you can sustain in that career. So I have a few bits of advice to give you about sustaining a career. First of all, be it right from the start. You have to be determined. There are so many young people out there whom I know have taken up certain careers, and then sometimes 1 or 2 months into the program, they decide that it's not for them. And they made a wrong choice. It wasn't an informed choice. And then they just don't want to follow through with it. But if you make an informed career choice and you're determined to sustain your career, then you make sure that you reach that pinnacle that you really wanted to reach. Follow your passion. Anything that's done without passion is not really going to make you feel good about doing. Because a career is not just a job. Also, you use the words career and job synonymously. They're actually different. Okay. So a career is something which is a part of your life. It's not just a job that gives you money, okay, that sustains your family just as a means of sustenance. It becomes a part of your life. So all your life, you're going to merge that career with yourself, with your living, with your lifestyle, with your relationships with people. It's all going to come out to you that way, even your interaction with the community. Okay? So follow your passion. Glamour. Okay. This is something which I often face with students. It's when they're in school, normally they say, I want to be a pilot because, I love the uniform. But there's a lot more to just wearing a uniform and into the health sciences. There are some youngsters at grade 12, they say, I always wanted to be a nurse because my mother's a nurse. And when they get there, they say, I thought that nurses just give drips and injections. I didn't know we had to do all the other things. So be prepared, know what you're getting into, just don't go by the glamour. Follow your passion, because your passion, you can only see it alive. Glamour can fade. Remember that learning is a lifelong process. All your life, you will keep learning. You have to upgrade yourself. There's so many things happening around us, and every day there's something new coming up. So be in touch with it and keep learning. Be flexible and enjoy what you do. Ms. Sudha mentioned this at the beginning of the session. You need to be flexible because there will be ups and downs. You know, getting into a career is not a straight line. There will be ups and downs, but you just need to enjoy what you do. And chillax, don't stress. There's so many kids out there who stress about not getting admission here, or they're not sure about what they're going to do, and they start stressing out. So just remember that we all have problems. Okay, everyone runs into problems, but every problem has a solution. Okay, and please do remember this one thing. This is a take-home message for you, is that you are more important than the problem. So you are important, and you have all the possibilities, people around you to support you to get through that stressful time. So never feel that you don't have anyone. Talk to someone, be confidential, and take care of yourself. So choosing the right career path is important, but remember that it's not a straight line. There always will be ups and downs. So now moving on to healthcare. Let's look at a few advantages of a career in healthcare. Since I'm representing a medical health science university, I'd like to talk about the advantages of healthcare. So this is a global need, okay, throughout the world, especially during the COVID crisis. We find a growing need for people in the healthcare services as a perennial need, not just globally, but perennial. Throughout the year, you'll find that you are needed. There's a growing demand for the careers in healthcare, and there's a lifelong demand. So there will always be need for someone in the healthcare. And there's a constant increase in avenues in healthcare. There is so much happening out there. There are lots of opportunities, and I will be showing you some of them on the next slides. So remember, you choose a job that you love, and you will never have to work a day in your life. And I can be proud to say that I'm doing that. I'm really happy with what I'm doing because I followed my passion and I'm enjoying what I'm doing right now with you.
Let me leave you with some of our details. These are my details. You can contact me, that's a WhatsApp number, my email ID and my Instagram ID. So don't just do your best, be your best. Okay? Thank you so much, Science India Forum, for this opportunity. And thank you for your attention.